Okay, let's do this.
Y en mi canal de YouTube tengo 135 millones de vistas. Y hoy estamos en el rancho de mi abuelo. ¡Miren!
She just looks at the camera and she's like happy.
Siempre me había gustado ser famosa y cuando vi que a la gente le encantó lo que hacía, pues yo me puse muy feliz, de en serio, porque me encanta grabar, me encanta ser feliz y poder transmitirlo a las personas, porque hay personas muy amargadas.
Hola, mi nombre es Jessica. Tal vez me conozcan como Jessie. Y hoy les voy a contar cómo mi vida cambió para siempre.
Les presento a Ligia, mi mamá. Ella es la persona más importante en mi vida y en la de mi hermano Pepe. Un día, yo vi que mi mamá no se sentía bien. El dolor era muy fuerte, pero a las pocas horas se le quitaba. De pronto el dolor era más fuerte y no sabíamos a qué se debía. Así que ella...
Tienes muchas vistas, millones, y ahora no es...
No tantas. Es que me fui un tiempo de YouTube porque pues mi mamá falleció, entonces me fui un tiempo porque no estaba bien y me fui.
¿Y estás mejor ahora? Te preocupas cuando no hay vistas, ¿no?
A veces sí. Porque me gustaba mucho que la gente viera mi contenido. O sea, es muy padre ser famosa.
I keep the bad comments away from her and I only show them the good, the nice comments. I even think that it's helping her with my mom's passing. I think it distracts her.
Para mí, yo digo que sí es mágico, que me siento mal, pero me pongo a grabar, se me olvida, es una terapia para mí.
You feel like you have a million friends.
Oh, me quiero ir.
Yo me quiero ir.
Done.
Es muy raro, no logro tener una dimensión de cuántas personas tengo como seguidores, como amigos, pero sé que es muchísima gente y a veces llega a espantar, llega a ser algo que da miedo. porque sí me sentía muy ansiosa de que no quería despertar, no quería levantarme de la cama, pero a la vez tenía esta presión de que lo tengo que hacer y ni modo, que sí llegué al límite de ya no quiero vivir. Y cuando yo dije, ok, si estoy pensando eso es porque en serio necesito la ayuda.
Sí,
ayuda. Bien. Amigos, realmente tengo pocos y mis seguidores es otro tipo de, es un público que viene para ser mis amigos, pero son amigos diferentes porque son amigos que esperan un contenido, no unos amigos que están para ayudarme en situaciones de me van a dar consejos o algo del estilo.
What's good, everybody? My name is Bobby Burns. I've been doing YouTube for 11 years and I currently live in Los Angeles, California. And apparently I'm the poster child for internet burnout. So, yeah. Bobby Burns 5.0. Why you so depressed? Sponsorships plus a Jeep. And I think I've put out like 900 to 1,000 videos. It's a lot. Yeah, so that's, I basically lived in YouTube for years and years and years.
Hey guys, so today's video is about being a child and having people know you for the art that you're making.
I did a video on Shane Dawson, who is a really, really large YouTuber. At that time, he wasn't as large.
Oh my God,
it's a good sign.
You smell good.
Hey. Oh, you do smell good.
And then I moved out here to do a series with him on his YouTube channel.
So unbelievably excited for this dude, and I'm leaving tomorrow. I'm moving to LA.
It kind of fell apart, didn't really work.
That feeling of letting down an audience, probably the most crushing feeling I've ever experienced.
But I think Bobby's lost his mind after meeting Shane. Imagine trying to be imitating Edgy with the name Bobby. Are you okay, Bobby? You look retarded. No, I know it's bad for me. I don't think I'm handling this in a good way.
But you're still doing it.
Of course. No, everyone, and influencers know this is bad for them. No one thinks that it's not. We film with the BBC. Yeah.
The BBC is around.
Guinea pig for BBC.
Yeah. Putting your personality out for people to judge on the internet is what you're doing, is you're creating a fake personality that people are supposed to think is you.
Hi, my name is Olivia Reams, and for the past 5 years, I've been studying anxiety disorders at the University of Cambridge.
When we spend time with other people, we're learning skills like empathy. We're learning how to have conversations with others, but you can't develop that if you're spending all of this time online. Today, a huge problem amongst young people is social anxiety disorder, which is marked by this difficulty in being part of social situations, interacting with others. When you're using superficial means like social media and to try to harvest a high number of likes so that you can see yourself as positively in positive terms, then that's when it becomes problematic.
Anytime I respond to like a DM that's like, you piece of whatever, they're immediately like, oh my God, I'm your biggest fan. I've been wanting to talk to you forever. I can't believe you finally responded and send all these happy emojis.
So they just want your attention.
Yeah, they want your attention over anything. I don't think my specific experience is gonna become the norm. I think the burnout experience. You put up a post and it gets 100 likes. You put up another post and it got 20. You're not gonna be happy with it. Like, even if you're not doing it as a business, that just tells you that thing isn't important. So you take it away. I feel like it's gonna be 10 years, 15 years from now. It's gonna be really interesting to see what happened to like me and everybody else who's doing this right now.